Once again, we celebrate the incarnation of God in the person of Jesus, the good news of great joy, the feast of Christmas. A lot has happened since last Christmas. So much has changed for all of us, and we live with uncertainty about the future. What we can be certain of is the comfort we will find in the presence of Jesus in the manger. In Christ, God threw his tent among us, leaving behind his glory and the power to be with us as one of us and to show the way to be truly human. Yes, God's love came down. The incarnation means that God became human as a part of created world. We believe that God is permanently incarnate in human history, not for a moment, but forever, and incarnation continues in our individual lives. With the cry of the earth and the cry of the poor getting louder and louder, let us ask ourselves with a heartfelt intent, what good works wait to be born in us? As he continues to make his birth present among us through each of his creation, in Fratelli Tutti, Pope Francis writes that a worldwide tragedy like the COVID-19 pandemic momentarily revived the sense that we are a global community, revealing once more the inevitable and blessed awareness that we are part of one another, we are brothers and sisters of one another, we are all called, just like the Good Samaritan, to become neighbors to others, overcoming prejudices, divisions, personal interest, deep-seated racism, and historic and cultural barriers, because love builds bridges and we are made for love. The culture of encounter invites us to incarnate God's love in our words and actions, so that each life is respected and recognized as having dignity. The incarnation is God's method of communicating good news to us. The good news is that God is infinite in love and intimate in love, far beyond us, yet intensively close to us, and thus bridging the great chasm between God's world and our world. So incarnation offers hope, also poses a challenge to all of us, that Jesus to be born in us and we reincarnate him in today's context by becoming his instrument of peace, love and service. Are we willing and ready? What is ours to do during this challenging time? Let us welcome Jesus, who comes to us with the good news of providence, healing, forgiveness, compassion and peace to be born in us. With this hope and expectation, let us celebrate again the Christmas. Wishing you a grace-filled Christmas and Happy New Year.